video is called Forgive and Forget. And if I move around a lot, it's because I'm getting ready for school. So, basically, I just want to talk about forgiving somebody and just forget the problems. It's easy to forgive and forget, in my opinion.
Oh, it's bad.
Because if you, I think if you hold a grudge, it brings you down in life. Like, I think it'll just bring you down more. And I think if you hold that grudge, you'll be depressed for a while. And honestly, you don't want to be depressed. Like, I don't think you purposely make yourself depressed.
Yes.
What, you just want to look at my video?
I'm sorry.
Oh.
Sorry.
Ow.
I
I'm not going to start. It's easier to forgive and forget. So, because, alright, I'll give you two examples of how I forgive and I forgot. One was this girl. I really liked her. I brought her a rose and I asked her out. She said she wasn't ready for a boyfriend. Next day, she has a boyfriend. Now, I was just aggravated. I was so mad. When someone told me how sad she was, how depressed she was, and how depressed I saw myself, I had to overcome that. I had to forgive. So I forgave her. That was kind of weak, but I posted on her Facebook wall. It's easier to forgive and forget. I haven't been about that my whole life. So, there's one. This is happening in the same, this other story happened in the same place. There's this kid. I get it, my cousin calls him Ginger. Is he? I don't know. Sounds great. We would always fight. Back to 7th grade, I'm in high school now, so 9th grade, so 2 years. 7th grade, we would fight constantly. And once again, one of the fights was over his girlfriend, because I kind of liked her. But that's a whole different story. And then 7th grade, so we fought a lot. Not like physically, because I don't. We fighting, whatever. That was the gayest thing I just did. Man, that's it. Anyways, 8th grade year, I moved. If you guys see a lot of different places, I moved a lot. So, I came back this year, the 9th for high school, hopefully I say. Just like that, we're cool. We just hang out, he's on math class, so we have fun there. But we forgave each other and we forgot. That's what I lived by my whole life. What I'm starting to live by. To forgive and forget. If you just constantly keep a grudge, you will be depressed and you will be sad. And you don't want to be sad, do you? No. Unless you're really stupid and you think that's what you want to do to get attention. Honestly, I like being happy. You know, I like being happy. There's no reason for me to be sad. I have a pretty good life. I have amazing friends. So, just try to, if there's someone going on in their life, making a video here.
I need my backpack.
Okay, good. You have your backpack. It's my brother George. Just, yeah. forgive and forget. I honestly think that's the easiest way to go. Just to forgive. Some examples, well, say, okay, the littlest thing, because I know that if you're kindergartners, that kind of gets aggravated, you tug, because if you're like one of those really weird kindergartners, you're just like, I'm gonna pull her head off. But hopefully, she forgives and forgets. That's a weird example. Okay, so, high school, someone takes her girlfriend. Now, I can understand you'd be majorly PO'd. But you can't get mad at that. Maybe she lost feelings for you. Maybe it just wasn't meant to be. If it was by your best friend, forgive and forget. It's the easiest way to go. I did. She was dating my best friend. My best friend knew it. I forgave and I forgot. If it's gonna be a weird one, but it's like someone murdered your family. Forgive that murderer and forget. Your life will go on. I understand that your one of your family members is dead. Forgive and forget. You will feel so much better. And if you don't, I don't know what to tell you, but try to. I love you all. And if I have made you mad at any part of this video, please forgive and forget.